If you want to live stream on Facebook groups with Cinamaker, watch this video at the very end and I'll show you how in just a few steps. Let's roll. Hi, I'm Tolis, Dokianos, video marketing pro and live streaming enthusiast, and welcome to my desk. I'm sat here in front of my computer because I want to jump right in and show you the process that you need to follow so that you can live stream on Facebook. Now, recently, Facebook came up with a new privacy measure, which isn't very obvious when you add a third-party app to your group. I stumbled on the solution after a few painstaking searches, so make sure you follow these next few steps and you'll be streaming in no time. Now, from your Facebook page, go to groups on the left-hand side here. Select one of the groups you manage, and for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to select my private test group. Then under admin tools, scroll down to group settings. Now, scroll all the way down to Manage Advanced Settings. Click on the pencil icon and scroll down to the bottom of the Group Apps window and click on Add Apps. Next, search for Cinamaker in the search field. The Cinamaker Director app logo will then appear. Now just click on it, then click Add, and you should get a notification on that says the app has been successfully added to your group. Now here's a very important next step. In order for Director Studio to be authorized for use on your Facebook group next time you want to live stream, you need to allow apps to access infos such as your name and profile picture. This basically means you consent to the app to making your name, profile picture, and video content visible to your group. This is that little catch that I was talking to you about. So, now go back to your group's discussion feed and look for the post that shows you added a third party app in the group. In this case, look for a post that says manage Cinamaker Director Pad's access to your info. Now just click on manage access, tick the box to allow Cinamaker to post content on your behalf, and the job's a good one. Now launch the Cinamaker Capture app on all of your devices, then launch Director Studio on your iPad. Start a new session, wait for all your cameras to connect, and then click the record button, which will take us to the control panel. Now, click on Facebook on top here, select your privacy settings, keep your resolution and video streaming quality to a default for now. Next, look for the group you've just given Cinamaker access to. Here you go. Now add the title of your live stream in the video title field. Here's an expert tip. Make sure you use a well thought out and properly written title, because that's what's going to appear on the post when you go live. That's what people are actually going to see. So you need to make your title count. Use a title that's going to resonate with your audience. And in this case, I'm going to use something very simple: how to live stream on Facebook with Cinamaker. Now let's test it. Now hit the start button and give it a few seconds before you can see your live stream on another computer or mobile device. You can use that device to read and respond to live comments, which is awesome for managing and administrating comments. And just to be clear, your audience can watch on any device they choose to access Facebook. They don't need to be using Cinamaker. Only you do, as the producer director of your live stream. They do not, okay? Now, there will be a delay of approximately 15 to 60 seconds in my experience between your broadcast and the stream in your group's feed. So don't be surprised if you don't see your live stream immediately in your group feed. Don't let that throw you off. Once your live stream is finished, Facebook's going to process the recording for more people to watch. And once the recording has been posted, you can go back and edit the post and add some additional comments. In the meantime, check out more Cinamaker videos up here, and I'll see you in my next video.